greed invade my mind and remain. MI 91, all of which should be quoted. The second path, third noble person. 22 However, after reviewing in this way, either while sitting in the same session or on another occasion, the noble disciple who is a stream enterer makes it his task to reach the second plane by attenuating both greed for sense desires and ill will. He brings to bear the faculties 6 the powers, and the enlightenment factors, and he works over and turns up that same field of formations, classed as materiality, feeling, perception, formations, and consciousness, with the knowledge that they are impermanent, painful, not self, and he embarks upon the progressive series of insights. 23 When he has 677 done so, and when, at the end of equanimity about formations, conformity, and change of lineage 7 knowledge have arisen in a single adverting in the way already described, then the path of once return arises next to change-of-lineage. The knowledge associated with that is knowledge of the path of once return. The second kind of knowledge is ended. The second fruition, fourth noble person. 24 The fruition consciousness should be understood to follow immediately upon this knowledge in the same way as before. And at this point this once returner is called the fourth noble person. He is bound to make an end of suffering after returning once to this world. Next there comes reviewing in the way already described. The third path, fifth noble person. 25 Now, after reviewing in this way, either while sitting in the same session or on another occasion, this noble disciple who is a once returner makes it his task to reach the third plane by abandoning, without remainder, both greed for the sense desires and ill will. He brings to bear the faculties, the powers, and the enlightenment factors, and he works over and turns up that same field of formations with the knowledge that they are impermanent, painful, not self, and he embarks upon the progressive series of insights. 26 When he has done so, and when, at the end of equanimity about formations, conformity, and change of lineage have arisen in a single adverting in the way already described, then the path of non-return arises next to change-of-lineage. The knowledge associated with that is knowledge of the path of non-return. The third kind of knowledge is ended. The third fruition, sixth noble person. 27 The fruition consciousnesses should be understood to follow immediately upon this knowledge in the same way as before. And at this point this non-returner is called the sixth noble person. After death he reappears apparition ally elsewhere and attains complete extinction there without ever returning, without ever coming to this world again through rebirth linking. Next there comes reviewing in the way already described. The fourth path, seventh noble person. 28 Now, after reviewing in this way, either while sitting in the same session or on another occasion, this noble disciple who is a non-returner makes it his task to reach the fourth plane by abandoning, without remainder, greed for the fine material and immaterial, conceit, pride, agitation, and ignorance. He brings to bear the faculties, the powers, and the enlightenment factors, and he works over 678 and turns up that same field of formations with the knowledge that they are impermanent, painful, not self, and he embarks upon the progressive series of insights. 29 When he has done so, and when, at the end of equanimity about formations, conformity, and change of lineage have arisen in a single adverting, then the path of arahantship arises next to change of lineage. The knowledge associated with that is knowledge of the path of arahantship. The fourth kind of knowledge is ended. The fourth fruition, eighth noble person. 30 The fruition consciousness should be understood to follow immediately upon this knowledge in the same way as before. And at this point this arahant is called the eighth noble person. He is one of the great ones with cankers destroyed, he bears this last body, he has laid down the burden, reached his goal and destroyed the fetter of becoming, he is rightly liberated with final knowledge and worthy of the highest offering of the world with its deities. 31 So when it was said above, however, purification by knowledge and vision properly consists in knowledge of the four paths, that is to say, the path of stream entry, the path of once return, the path of non-return, and the path of arahantship, 2, that referred to these four kinds of knowledge to be reached in this order. to the states associated with the path, etc. 32. Now, in order to appreciate the value of this same purification by knowledge and vision with its four kinds of knowledge. 1. Fulfillment of states sharing in enlightenment. 2. Emergence, and 3. The coupling of the powers. 4. The kinds of states that ought to be abandoned. 5. Also the act of their abandoning. 6. Functions of full understanding, and the rest as stated when truths are penetrated to. 7. Each one of which ought to be recognized according to its individual essence. 33.1. Herein, the fulfillment of states sharing in enlightenment is the fulfilledness of those states partaking in enlightenment. For they are the following 37 states, the four foundations of mindfulness, MN10, the four right endeavors, M211, the four roads to power, MI103, the five faculties, M212, the five powers, M212, the seven enlightenment factors, MI11, and the Noble Eightfold Path, D2311F. And they are called partaking of enlightenment because they take the part of the Noble Eightfold Path, which is called enlightenment in the sense of enlightening, and they take the part of that because they are helpful. 8. 34. Foundation, Pahana, is because of establishment, Upahana, by going down into, by descending upon, such and such objects. 9. Mindfulness itself as foundation, establishment, is foundation of mindfulness. It is of four kinds because it occurs with respect to the body, feeling, consciousness, and mental objects, Dhamma, taking them as foul, painful, impermanent, and non-self, and because it accomplishes the function of abandoning perception of beauty, pleasure, permanence, and self. 679. That is why four foundations of mindfulness is said. 35. By it they endeavor, Padahanti, thus it is endeavor, Padhana, a good endeavor is a right, Sama, endeavor. Or alternatively, by its means people endeavor rightly, Samapadahanti, thus it is right endeavor, Samapadhana. Or alternatively, it is good because of abandoning the unseemliness of defilement, and it is endeavor because of bringing about improvement and giving precedence, Padhana Bhavakaro, in the sense of producing well-being and bliss, thus it is right endeavor. It is a name for energy. It accomplishes the functions of abandoning arisen unprofitable things, preventing the arising of those not yet arisen, arousing unarisen profitable things, and maintaining those already arisen, thus it is fourfold. That is why four right endeavors is said. 36. Power, iti, is in the sense of success, ijhana, as already described, 12.44. It is the road, basis, pitta, to that power, for that success, iti, in the sense of being the precursor of that success which is associated with it and in the sense of being the prior cause of that success which is its fruit, thus it is a road to power, basis for success. It is fourfold as zeal, desire, and so on. That is why four roads to power are spoken of, according as it is said, four roads to power. The road to power consisting in zeal, the road to power consisting in energy, the road to power consisting in natural purity of consciousness, the road to power consisting in inquiry, Vibhite 223. These are supramundane only. But because of the words, if a bhikkhu obtains concentration, obtains mental unification by making zeal predominant, this is called concentration through zeal, Vibhite 216, etc., they are also mundane as states acquired by predominance of zeal, etc., respectively. 37. Faculty is in the sense of predominance, in other words, of overcoming, because these states, as faculties respectively overcome faithlessness, idleness, negligence, distraction, and confusion. Power is in the sense of unwaveringness because these states, as powers are incapable of being overcome respectively by faithlessness, and so on. Both are fivefold as consisting in faith, energy, mindfulness, concentration, and understanding. That is why five faculties and five powers is said. 38 Mindfulness, investigation of states, energy, happiness, tranquility, concentration, and equanimity as factors in a being who is becoming enlightened, are the seven enlightenment factors. And right view, right thinking, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, and right concentration are the eight path factors in the sense of being an outlet. Hence, seven enlightenment factors and the Noble Eightfold Path is said. 39 So there are these 37 states partaking of enlightenment. Now, in the prior stage when mundane insight is occurring, they are found in a plurality of consciousnesses as follows. The foundation of mindfulness consisting in contemplation of the body is found in one discerning the body in the 14 ways. 10 The foundation of mindfulness consisting in contemplation of feeling, in one discerning feeling in the 9 ways. The foundation of mindfulness consisting in the contemplation of mind, in one discerning the manner of consciousness in 16 ways. 680 The foundation of mindfulness consisting in contemplation of mental objects, in one discerning mental objects in the 5 ways. And at the time when, on seeing an unprofitable state arisen in someone else, which has not yet arisen in his own person, he strives for its non-arising thus, I shall not behave as he has done in whom this is now arisen, and so this will not arise in me, then he has the first right endeavor, when, seeing something unprofitable in his own behavior, he strives to abandon it, then he has the second, when he strives to arouse jhana or insight so far unarisen in this person, he has the third. And when he arouses again and again what has already arisen so that it shall not diminish, he has the fourth. And at the time of arousing a profitable state with zeal as the motive force, there is the road to power consisting in zeal, and so on with the remaining 3 roads to power. And at the time of abstaining from wrong speech there is right speech, and so on with abstaining from wrong action and wrong livelihood. 11. At the time of arising of any one of the 4 kinds of path knowledge, all these states are found in a single consciousness. In the moment of fruition the 33 accepting the 4 right endeavors are found. 40 When these are found in a single consciousness in this way, it is the one kind of mindfulness whose object is nibbana that is called the 4 foundations of mindfulness because it accomplishes the function of abandoning the 4 perceptions of beauty, etc., in the 4 things beginning with the body. And also the one kind of energy is called 4 right endeavors because it accomplishes the 4 functions beginning with preventing the arising of the unarisen. Unprofitable. But there is no decrease or increase with the rest. 41 Furthermore it is said of them. 9 in one way, 1 in 2 ways, then in 4 ways, and in 5 ways, in 8 ways, and in 9 ways, 2, so in 6 ways they come to be. 42 9 in one way, these 9 are zeal, consciousness, happiness, tranquility, equanimity, thinking, speech, action, and livelihood, and they are found in one way as road to power consisting in zeal, etc., since they do not belong to any other.